Welcome back, baseball fans, for game four in the National League North series. We have a game four. We have the Reds at Pittsburgh in a game four. First, we'll see what the schedule entails for this game four. The series is Pittsburgh at Cincinnati. Cincinnati has a plus two in the tiebreaker. They're three games ahead in the standings, so Pittsburgh has to win 5 of 7. They finish in a tie, and they'd claim the tiebreaker, and they wouldn't have to play the eighth game. So Pittsburgh needs to win 5 out of 7. So this is what's happened. In game one, the Reds won at home 3-2. Really tough game between Gullett and Blass. Tough loss for the Pirates, 3-2 in that one. In game two in Cincinnati, this is a good game, number two. Hey, the Pirates, they won 5-4. And it was good to see that in the ninth inning, Pittsburgh called on Dave Justy, who had three losses in their last series. But they called on him again in a save situation. He was shaky, very shaky. He gave up a solo homer and loaded the bases, but he got the final out. And the Pirates left Riverfront with a split. So now they're three games back, but there's only five left. We'll set up game number three in Cincinnati. Set up game three back in Pittsburgh. Three River Stadium in Pittsburgh. But in this game, Rick Rodin, all-star starter, led the National League in ERA. But it was only 3-0 because of all these no decisions. He pitched brilliantly for 6 2/3, but he was victimized by two solo home runs by none other than Johnny Bench. And after that, after coming out, once again, the Pittsburgh bullpen reverted to their past failures. Eric Davis hits a two-run homer off of Bruce Kieson. Tony Perez hits a two-run homer off Gary Lucas. It's 6-0, and it's Jim Maloney, the number three starter, very good number three starter for the Reds, throws a 7-hit shutout with 3 walks and 5 Ks, and the Reds win 2 of the first 3 games, setting up a game four elimination game, because the Pirates need 4 straight wins with 4 remaining. And in game four, the pitching matchup, it will be John Candelaria, the lefty, in game four for the Pirates, and John Butcher for the Big Red Machine. We're going to change the Red lineup. The Pirates are going to go with the same lineup they had in the last game. Actually, you know what? In the last game, two of their players got hurt. So they're gonna move Lacey back into the number two hole and drop Hebner to 7. So we're gonna do this right on the fly here. Lacey 2, Hebner 7. And for the Big Red Machine, we're gonna change their lineup on the fly right now. Against a lefty, they have a different lineup for lefties versus righties. As Carbo sits, Eric Davis sits, Tom Foley sits. So we're going to plug in a new lineup shortly. Move Bench up into the cleanup spot. So this is the new lineup against lefties. This Pavletek guy is the leadoff DH because of his own base percentage. Caniglia bats 7th and left. Sepsione bats 8th and short. Eric Davis sits. Tom Foley sits. And Bernie Carbo sits. Tolan bats 3rd, Rostel bats 2nd, Perez bats 5th, Bench bats 4th. When you change all those numbers, you'll see that the lineup error goes away. You hit Control V. And just like that, your team's batting lineup is in the correct orders. You see Lacey batting 2nd, Pavletek leading off. And it'll be John Butcher, the number 4 starter for the Reds. Candelaria, the number 4 starter for the Pirates in a game 4 elimination. Pirates need this one badly. if they have any chance at a wild card. Here we go. Paveltech, 55. Off the Kindle area card. 1-6 double, that's a double. Pete Rose, 35, single, 1-16, he gets it. There are runners with the corners for Tolan. They got to bring it up for the 8 bunter. 47's a K for Candyman. Johnny Bench, 2 homers last game. This one's a lefty question mark for Pavlotek. No, the slow-footed journeyman platoon catcher for the White Sox, who somehow got a roster spot, will stay at third with 2 outs in the first for Tony Perez. And Perez, 6-6, off of Candelaria's card, double, 1-13. That is a single, dot, dot, which scores 1 run. Rose goes to third. 2 outs for Lee May. And he skies the center field. All right, Matty Alou leads it off for the Pirates. Off of Butcher, catcher's card. And this is Johnny Bench, who's a 1E7. I should have memorized this by now, you'd think, as often as I looked at this guy's card. All right, 1 out, Lee Lacy. This guy's all right. 2 outs for Johnny Ray, first. Pirates need a spark, get back in the series. Canigliaro, lines a second. Concepcion, single 1-3 line out. And with 2 outs, Helms, short. Gosh, the Pirates are hoping they can win comfortably and not have to rely on their bullpen getting them the win. That's been their Achilles heel this year. Roberto Clemente. Strikes out. Willie Stargell bounces to short. This is Concepcion, a 3-16 at short. Not one of his better years. Base hit. Manny Sanguin, 38, is a single. 2-1 outs for Richie Hebner. Flies into right field. This is going to be Rose, is a 1-4 in right field. No such luck there. And with 2 outs, Al Oliver struck him out. Okay, third inning. Let's show the Paveltech card anyway. They just needed a guy to hit left-handed pitching to come off the bench. And he's very good against left-handers. And the Reds said, you know what? We're so darn good. We'll let him lead off. It doesn't matter that much. Base hit, Paveltech. He's 2-for-2. So there you go. And he scored the 1 run. Pete Rose, 2-3. Pops a second. Bobby Tolan, 1-3, okay. Bench. Homers off the Candelaria card on 5-4. Number 15, 16, number 17 for the possible National League Most Valuable Player. And it's 3-0 Reds against their hated division rival Pirates in Pittsburgh. This could be devastating for Pirates fans. Tony Perez, 6-11, flies a left. Lacy's a 3-1, makes the correct catch. Pittsburgh's got to come back. Gene Alley, 57, short. Concepcion's a 3-16 at short. He's out. I expect the Pirates to make a rally. They got a great offense. 54, skies it in the center. Tolan's a 2-9 with a good arm, but he gives up a single here. Now, again, you've got speed on the Pirates, but you got the minus 4 on the bench and a 3-0 lead, so he will stay at first. And Lee Lacy comes to the plate and hits a screamer in the left field. Niglier's got range, but not a 2-11. That's a single dot dot, and the Pirates have something going here. Johnny Ray, the Reds are playing back, holding for a double play for Johnny Ray with a big 3-0 lead. 46, sack fly to center. And Roberto Clemente, a base hit in the right field. Lacy, he's a great base runner, but you don't want to make that third out at third base and you're down 2. So it'll be first and second with 2 outs because they want Willie Stargell to bat against Butcher. Here in the bottom of the third. 48, though, lines the second base. Pops cannot come through. 3-1. Lee May, 58, left. Billy Canigliaro bounced to second. Concepcion, 56. Triple 1-6 is a base hit. Ace Stealer. With a lead, the Reds, he's going to try and steal. He steals second base off Sanguin. Nice base running move for Concepcion there. Getting in the scoring position with 2 outs for Tommy Helms, who pops it short. Bottom of 4. We got a 3-1 game. All these games have been tight. Sanguin, 2-7. Base hit. Tie run is Hebner. 48 lines a second. Al Oliver, 37's a single to center with one out. Sanguian would do it, except Tolan's got a minus two arm, so we'll stay put at second. First and second for Gene Tornado Alley, 212, fouls to the catcher, and with two outs, Matty Alou. Skies the center field. We go to the fifth, 3-1. Pavlotek, 412, finally got him out, finds a second. Pete Rose, 411, first. Tolan, 2-7, is a base hit. He's a double A. He will try a steal with a lead. And he gets it. Does he not get the T rating? No. So he's on second with two outs. Jeez, do you walk bench here? To face Tony Perez and Lee May? I mean, what are you supposed to do? Not be left-handed is what you're supposed to do. I think it's pretty weak to intentionally walk him. They'll pitch to bench, knowing the perils that can occur here. Johnny Bench, 3-11, is a walk. Well, he walked him anyway. 2-on-2 outs. This is a crucial batter. Tony Perez with two outs and two on. 2-10, bounces the third. All right. So, we get the homer off of Cantillero's card in the third. A run in the first. That's been it for the Reds. It's a 3-1 game. Bottom of the fifth. Pirates, they need to get going here. Lee Lacy, 47, pops the second. Pops the second base. Johnny Ray, 412, flies left. Roberto Clemente, 52, flies left. The Pirate offense is way too stagnant here. 3-1 in the sixth. It's not going well at all. Lee May, 5-10, catcher's card. This is Sanguian to three. Billy Conigliaro, 1-6, left, and with two outs, Concepcion. Concepcion, 5-4, again off the Candelaria card. It's Homer. If he's got power, and he does, it's a solo shot for Dave Concepcion. It's 4-1 Reds. Tom Helms, Candelaria's a starter, 6. One more batter, base runner, and he is gone. Flies right. Couple of homers off the Candelaria cards, the difference of the game, 4-1. Willie Stargell, bottom of six. 2-9K. Sanguian, 2-8 single. Richie Hebner, 5-10. Walk off Butcher. He's a starter, 6, so he can't lose. You break him, he's gone. Al Oliver, 67, you broke him. The center field, base hit. Sanguian will not try and score here. That will cause Butcher to exit in the sixth. And now we got Alley, Alou, Lacy, and Ray. And the Reds need to go to their bullpen. Interestingly, John Franco, if any of you have watched the All-Star game, John Franco pitched 6 innings in the All-Star game. And fortunately for the Reds, he's not pitched in the series yet. So he got a day off at the All-Star break and 3 more days off in the series. So he should be fine, well rested at this point. 2-on, 3-on with 1 out. Righty, lefty, righty, lefty. So they're going to go with Wayne Granger. Wayne Granger in the 6th. The base is loaded at 1 out. Gene Alley, not a good bunter, so they can play back here with a big lead. Gene Alley, 1-6 with a big lead. Center be question mark. I think you got to try and get this run in. Sanguian. It's 1-14 with the arm, and he's out on a 15. Oh, that's horrible. Terrible. Sanguian gets thrown out of the plate, trying to make it a 2-run game in the 6th. He's a 1-14 runner. You get plus 2, makes it 16. But Bobby Tolan of the Bells has got a minus 2 arm, and miss it by 1, and the inning's over. That's a 9-9-2 double play. That's heartbreaking for the Pirates. We got a 4-1 game in the 7th. The Reds just seem to have the luck and everything going for them in this Cincinnati-Pittsburgh rivalry this year. Here we go. And the Reds are... was it plus 2? We'll look at it again. Here's Pavlotek's 4th and final at-bat here in the 7th inning. 2-7 is a walk. Running for Pavlotek. He got on base 3 times leading off. Running for him will be Eric Davis. Eric Davis will run for him. And he's got some speed. Pete Rose doesn't have power, so he'll hit. 4-8 off the candy card, rolls it to second. This is Johnny Ray. A 3-14 gets a force out. Bobby Tolan, 2-6, a single to center field. And here's Rose. You know he wants to chug around. 16. Alou plus two arm. 1-18 to go to 30. Does. Runners on the corners, and it's Johnny Bench. That's it. Candelaria leaves. You gotta take him out here. 6 1/3. Boy. I think you're going to bring Justy in early. Remember, he had trouble, as I said, losing games. He wouldn't lose this one. He had trouble closing games. We're going to bring him in the seventh inning in a big spot. Hope he's turned his troubles around. Johnny Bench. Yeah, that's a confidence booster. So you got runners on the corners with speed on the base and Johnny Bench at the plate. Tolan's not going anywhere. Runners on the corners, one out. They are going to, with Bench, in a risky move, they're going to play back for the double play attempt here. Out of Bench instead of bringing the infield up. So here's the pitch to Bench. Justy, 4-4 off Justy's card, is third X. The third baseman's a 3-26 Hebner. And it's going to roll the 26, and he gets a ground ball C, which moves the runners up. So Hebner bobbles the ball slightly. The runner scores from third, and that's a huge, huge insurance run. Now it's 5-1 with a runner at second. Another mistake for the Pirates. And Tony Perez, who strikes out. Perez will leave, and the Reds will move their infield around. Concepcion goes over to third. Foley, Tom Foley will play short. Wayne Granger has a 4-run lead the seventh. John Franco's warming. Here's Matty Alou. The Pirates are 9 outs away from being knocked out in this round after four. Matty Alou, 2-5 a single. Lee Lacy, 33, pops a second. Johnny Ray, 1-5, is a 4-6-3 double play. Johnny Ray. Oh, we're listening to The Intruders, a band from Pennsylvania, on Gamble Records. Had some great hits, Cowboys and Girls. It was a great hit, amongst many others. Great band, The Intruders. Eighth inning, 5-1 Pirates. Justy's still out there. Lee May. 4-4 Lee May, third X, and that's an out. This time Hebner makes a clean play. Canigliaro, short. Concepcion walks. He's going to try another steal. He steals another base off of Sanguian. And with two outs, Tommy Helms pops out. All right, 6 outs to go with a 4-run lead. You know John Franco's ready. Reds got all the defense they can think of in the game. We're 6 outs out. We got Clemente and then Stargell. He's pitching an inning and 2/3. We'll let him pitch to Clemente. If he gets on, we'll have a lefty pitch to Stargell. So here's Clemente, 38, no surprise, it's a single. And it's Stargell. That's it for Ranger. Augusto comes on in the eighth. The 4-run lead and 6 outs to get. They're going to empty this bullpen. Augusto, lefty specialist. Let's take a look at his card. Well, he's in there to face Stargell and Hebner. Now, you could pinch it for Stargell, which seems like a sacrilege, just because Augusto is so bad against right-handed pitching. Are we at that desperate a time? I think it is. Could you imagine that? So they're going to do it. They know how terrible Augusto is against right-handed pitching, so they're going to bat for pops with John Walkenfuss. Let's look at a Walkenfuss card. This is something you would never see in Pittsburgh. It would be a sacrilege to take Stargell out just because the pitcher's good against lefties. But in this particular situation, they're going to do it. They're going to do the analytic and have John Walkenfuss bat against Augusto. Here we go, Walkenfuss. The pitch. 35 is a walk. So he gets on base. Stargell would have gotten on base as well. Two on, Sanguian. Now, this is where Sanguian's can hit 400 against Augusto. So Sanguian, 55, gets the walk, and they're loaded. Now, if you're the Pirates, if you take Hebner out, you got Hebner and Oliver, back-to-back lefties. If you take Hebner out, we'll see somebody else. You're not going to have Augusto pitch to Tyron. But you know what? They're going to bat. They're going to pinch hit and bring in Bob Robertson. And that'll get Augusto out of there, who did nothing. And we're turning it over to Dave Schmidt. Let's look up Robertson's card. He actually has more homers against righties. So, formerly the Pirate bullpen was imploding. Right now, looks like the Red bullpen's not very stable. Dave Schmidt comes on in the eighth inning with the bases loaded, no one out, to face Bob Robertson. A grand slam ties this game. Here's the pitch to Bob Robertson. 4-10 off the Schmidt card, bouncer to third. It's not Tony Perez who started the game. It's the new third baseman. It's Concepcion. He's a 3E16. It's not an error. So here's the play by Concepcion. It's a fielder's choice. So that gets one run in. You still have runners on the corners. And you can still have the tie run bat. And it's going to be Al Oliver against Schmidt. If I wanted to, with only Roberto Pina on the bench, I could have John Franco come on in and be the last pitcher, just like the All-Star game when he was the last pitcher. So he will try and get a five-out save in a potential elimination game of the Pirates in the round of seven. So, Franco will come on in the eighth with two on and one out and face Al Oliver. And he's the last pitcher in the Red bullpen. So, they'll play back for Oliver. And I could pinch hit. The last ready on the bench is Roberto Pena. But Oliver's pretty good against lefties. So Oliver will bat with runners on the corners. Al Oliver. The pitch to Al Oliver, 58, is a second X. And that's the wrong guy to hit it to. You need a miracle now, because this is Tommy Helms is a 1E10 at second base. And you need some help here, Pittsburgh. 1E10, there's your double play. Hit it to the wrong spot. Tommy Helms is outstanding second baseman. Oliver gets the double play, and our man John Franco is having a magical season. Gets out of the inning. We have a 5-2 game going to the ninth. Justy's going 5/3. We got three lefties. Brewster will come on and pitch the ninth, as he's a righty who's good against lefties. Let's show Brewster's card. So Eric Davis. 2-8 bounces to short. Pete Rose, 1-9 single. Bobby Tolan, 46, single to right field. You know Rose is going to run. Oh, this is it. Rose versus Clemente. No. Rose is too smart. He ain't going to fall for that. He's not going to run off of Clemente. So first and second with one out. And here's Johnny Bench. 33 pops a second, and with two outs, it's Tom Foley in for defense for Tony Perez, and he lines the short. So Franco, he's got a three-run lead. It's a save situation. He won the All-Star game, has a chance to really put a hurt on the Pirates, bitter division rival. It's Gene Alley, Matty Alou, Lee Lacy in the ninth, with Roberto Pena on the bench. Here's Gene Alley. 57, Gene Alley K's. Matty Alou, 58, bounces the second. This is Helms again, 1E10. And with two outs, it's up to Lee Lacy. The pitch to Lee Lacy, 34, rolls to short. He is like clockwork. John Franco having a magical year as a closer. And the Reds and their bullpen and their team just has it over the Pirates this year. They win this game. They win 3 out of 4. Extend their lead to 5 over the Pirates. Now the Cubs will move into second place. And the Pirates' season is falling apart. Let's do the box score. Wow. So Brewster pitched the 9th. He gave up 2 hits. Just a inning and 2/3. He actually did very well. Gave up a walk and a K. Candelaria had kind of a shaky start. Gave up 9 hits and 5 runs. The big home runs off his card. Everything was earned. Walked 2, struck out 2. John Franco, a great save. Gets a double play in the 8th, strikes out a guy in the 9th. Dave Schmidt got one of the outs in the 8th. He faced Bob Robertson. Augusto walked 2 batters in that inning, neither scored. Granger gave up a hit in that inning, and he did actually score. He came on in the 6th, though. Granger pitched an inning in 2/3. Got the big double play. Wow. So Butcher actually gets the win. He pitched 5 1/3 innings. The Reds never lost the lead. He gave up 10 hits and a run in the 3rd, a walk and 3 strikeouts. So here's your box: 1019, 0109, 511, 211, 3334. Same number of base runners for each team. 14 base runners apiece. The Reds are just more efficient. Just a better team. That was game number 4. So with game 4, let's look at the year to date. That series ended very early. Too early for the Pirates, who are in a little bit of trouble now. So the Reds, they needed to improve their winning percentage. And we'll show you how much they improved. So the Pirates are now 16-17 because the Reds have beat them up pretty good recently. And look at the Reds, they're 21-12. And then if you look at the standings now in that division, the Reds, they have a 4-game lead over the Cubs, who move into second place. Boy, the Pirates, they were tied for first with the Reds a couple series ago. And Cincinnati now, wow, they won 4-2, they won 7-3. They beat the Reds Cincinnati beat Pittsburgh 7 out of 10 times. And I don't know if the Cubs can catch them or not. Can the Cubs catch the Reds? I don't know if they'll have enough time to do it. But that does it for the National League North. Hope you enjoyed the game. We'll catch you again next time.